6 and on stop.
26.
Northbound 5 to Northbound 5 to Overlake. Adam Charles, Nora 0852. Driver's check when ready.
Northbound
952,
and then registration is 0852.
To Overlake.
And go ahead, first part of registration.
Adam Charles North, 0852. You said you had prior suspension.
I did? Does it say I don't?
Yeah, it says you don't.
Oh. Does it go away when you pay them off or something?
No.
Oh, I've heard. I've gotten letters for you suspended before. That's why I told you it was, so.
Yeah. Well, I don't have many people tell me that they have multiple suspensions.
Yeah.
Oh. All right. I have to read you something. You have the right to remain silent. You have the right at this time to an attorney. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to talk to an attorney before answering any questions. You have the right to have an attorney present during questioning. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed for you without cost if you so desire. You can exercise these rights at any time. Do you understand these rights?
Yes.
After being informed of your rights, are you still willing to talk to me at this time?
Yes.
Okay. So we'll get you done and out of here. You don't have any more weed in the car?
No, not at all.
What's in the trunk?
Nothing at all. Jumper cables.
Just jumper cables?
Yeah.
Wow.
I just cleaned out my car yesterday. And I got it last year, so I don't really keep it that messy.
Okay. And there's no other weed in the car? Are there any pills in the car?
Nope.
Cocaine?
Nope.
Heroin?
Nope.
What else? Methamphetamine?
No.
Guns?
No.
Nuclear chemical weapons?
No bombs, nothing.
Nothing?
No exciting things for you today.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah.
Those things I can actually deal without.
Okay, good.
I would have no problem with not ever running into those.
I hope you haven't, and I hope you do.
Guns I run into all the time, but the rest of it, I hope I don't.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you for consent to search your car. I got to read you a couple things. And then, we'll get you out of here. All right.
Trying to get comfortable.
Yeah, that's not possible.
Yeah, I think so.
Only, the only people that can get comfortable in this car, or any police car is, anymore, are you gotta be drunk.
Yeah, really.
That's the only possible way.
Yeah, I have an itch on my shoulder.
That is the only way to be comfortable and fall asleep in a police car.
What would happen if I didn't give you consent to search my car?
Well,
I'm just wondering.
I would see if there's a canine dog available. See if they can sniff the car. And then I would apply for a search warrant.
Oh,
and take it to my office and apply for a search warrant.
Do you clean your cars every time you, like, pick up a nasty drunk dude back here?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then they spray it out.
Yeah.
Alright, Mrs. Graham.
Mm-hmm.
So what's going to happen is, I'm going to read you this. It's a consensus search form made up by the Washington State Patrol.
Oh, shoot, you will find a little, case in my front console, and it has, three pills in it.
Mm-hmm.
They are Percocet, and I have a prescription for them, but the prescription is at home, and I just keep a couple pills on me just in case my back starts hurting, because I got in a car accident a few months ago. So, those are in there.
So, what you're going to need to do is, I need you to... show me a valid prescription.
That I don't have on me.
I'm not right now.
Oh.
But you need to somehow get me a copy of the pill bottle.
How would I do that?
Copy it and send it to me.
Like,
and I'll
like when I go home or something?
Once you're done.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay, I can do that.
That way I don't have to charge you with a felony.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Thank you.
Yep. All right, you got to understand that you have the right to refuse consent to search your car. Hold on. That you have the right to limit the scope of the search to certain areas, and you have the right to withdraw the consent to stop the search at any time. Further, and you have to understand that you have the right to refuse permission to make such search and require the officer to obtain a search warrant. I realize that any items found may be used as evidence against me in subsequent legal proceedings. I just have to make sure that your consent has been given knowingly, freely, and voluntarily without threats or duress against your persons or property or promise of reward. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
So what I'm going to have you do is, I'm going to have, because I did it audio with the camera, I'm not as worried about you signing it right this second. Once I let you out, then I'm going to ask you to sign it.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Are you willing to sign it and give me consent to search your car?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to roll your window down a little bit. So if at any point you wanted to stop the search or... limit me from going into certain areas, you can yell out the car and I can come and talk to you, okay? Actually, you're in handcuffs, so I'll have you come out.
I'm what?
I'm going to have you come out of the car.
Okay.
Instead of doing
Thank
that.
You. Yeah, I made sure I was watching my speed because I knew that you were behind me. I don't think I went over more than 70. I mean, any pass.
Yeah, you were doing 75 at one point, and then you sped up to about 72 after that motorcycle cop passed you.
Thank you.
oxy? Use an oxy? enough cotton in there.
I don't like it rattling around in my bag. I can get my
bag. 4-7 Charlie, California registration and driver's check.
my car turned off and everything?
It will be in 2 seconds. 10-2-6-0-2-0-2.
Am I going to jail?
Yes.
When do you think I would be released?
Do you have any other drug charge? You have the marijuana charge?
Yeah.
Is that all you have?
Yeah.
I can't say when they will release you. Then it all does depend on your history. And I'll tell you, if the pills...
I have a prescription for them, though.
But how you're smoking it, it makes it illegal.
That's just the way that I choose to do it. I can't at school. Did you put my cigarettes in my purse?
No. They're in your car.
This is impound?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks, man. If I take him with us, we're going to throw him away in the jail.
Do you
want
going?
King County Jail.
Would I be able to call my mom and tell her?
sir? Well, you want your copy, don't you?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Drop that in the Kindle.
Yeah,
he's gonna do that.
Following
the vehicle to the bullpen. Can you make sure you roll out the windows for me?
Huh?
Can you make sure?
Yeah, I'll roll. I'll make sure.
Thanks. ma'am, what's the phone number you can be reached at?
What?
What's the phone number you can be reached at?
206-335-7885.
Who should I contact in case of an emergency?
My mom.
What's her name?
Betsy Andrews Grimm.
Betsy?
Betsy Grimm. B-E-T-S-Y. 1-T.
Oh, 1-T. And what's her address?
Same as mine.
What's her phone number?
206-335-7884. Did he roll my windows up?
Yeah, he did.
Thank you. Do I need to be handcuffed while I'm back here?
Yeah.
Okay. Not sure where she's going to end up this evening, but we're going to be on 156 right by the office on 759 Tom, John, Nora, and she's chosen to turn left on to Southeast 30th Place.
110-858.
Call my school again and tell them I won't be there at all.
Yep. We'll be there in a couple minutes.
Oh, I didn't want to use my cell phone?
Uh-uh.
I don't know the number otherwise.
Turn on 6. Turn on.
Yes, it'll clear Charles, I'll be on our number two. All folks coming on to Everett, or coming out to get the speed of Everett, sir.
One panel, sir.
Sir Charles, have it number two, and if you'll have the key ready for me to get into the bolt, that'd be great.
One ten, enter.
There's a guy behind you. I don't know if he can get out or not.
No, he's just not very bright. Oh, you're stopped. I'm going to stop with you.
Hey, did it still clear, yeah?
You know how to spell Percocet?
What?
You know how to spell Percocet?
I think it's P-E-R-C-O-C-E-T, I think.
I
need to call my school before 9:30.
Okay, we'll be there by 9:30. Transporting 1 to Unit 4. Beginning mileage 422.
Be 190, 34, Arizona. nearby, so last I have enough to do. Looks like 597 and Victor David, Arizona.
Thank you.
I'll put my business card in your wallet with his phone number on the back of it.
Okay.
If you decide you want to help yourself out.
Okay.
Is that something you might be interested in doing or not?
I'll think about it. When would I talk to a detective?
When you get out. Where, what area do you normally buy in?
C-Tech area.
In C-Tech? I don't want to waste his time. If that's not something you're going to do, Dana, you understand? So what I'll do is I will put my business card with his name and phone number on the back of it.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
He's a pretty busy guy, so you're going to just have to kind of try to get a hold of him, all right?